Hello friends, today I am going to teach the topic on perennial care. So starting from the introduction, perennial care is the act of washing the genital and rectal areas of the body. It should be done at least once a day during bed bath, shower or tub bath. It is done more often when a patient is incontinent. This prevents infections, odors and irritation. So perennial care is the act of washing the genital. It means related to the reproductive organs. And rectal, it means related to the rectum areas of the body. So it must be done at least once a day during bed bath, shower or tub bath. This is done more often when a patient is incontinent. It means lacking self-control. This prevents infections, odors and irritation. So next is definition. Perennial care involves washing the external genitalia and surrounding with soap and water or with water alone or in combination with any commercially prepared peri wash. It involves washing the external genitalia and surrounding with a soap and water or with water alone or in combination with any commercially prepared peri wash. So next is anatomy and physiology of perineum. External genitalia, vulva. Vulva means the female external genitalia. The external genitalia are known collectively as the vulva and consist of the labia majora and labia minora. The clitoris, the vaginal orifice, the vestibule, the hymen and the vestibular glands. Next is labia minora. Labia minora, it means the smaller inner folds of vulva. These are smaller folds, skin between the labia majora containing numerous sebaceous and recurring swept gland. Next is labia majora. This is the larger outer folds of the vulva. These are two large folds forming the boundary of the vulva. They are the composed of fibrous tissue and fat covered in skin and containing large number of sebaceous and recurring swept gland. Anteriorly, the folds join the front of the symphysis pubic and posteriorly they merge with the skin of the perineum at puberty. Hair grows on the mons pubic and on the lateral surface of the labia majora. Next is clitoris. It means a small mass of erectile tissue in the female that is situated at the anterior apex of the vulva. The clitoris corresponds to the penis in the male and contains sensory nerve ending and erectile tissue. So next is vestibular gland. It means a gland that opens into the vestibular of the vagina. The vestibular glands are situated one on each side near the vaginal opening. They are about the size of small pea and their duct open into the vestibular immediately lateral to the attachment of the hymen. They secrete mucus that kept the vulva moist. So next is perineum. It means area between the anus and the vulva. The perineum is a roughly triangular area extending from the base of the labia minora to the anal canal. It consists of connective tissue, muscle and fat. It gives attachment to the muscle of the pelvic floor. So next is the diagram of external genitalia of the female. Next is perineal care. Cleaning of the external genitalia, perineum and surrounding area. Perineal care is also referred to as pedic care or perineal genital care. Perineal care involves washing the external genitalia with soap and water or with water along or in combination with any commercially prepared peri wash. It may be carried out as part of the patient bath or as a separate procedure. The perineal area is conductive to the growth of pathogenic organism because it is warm, moist and is not well ventilated. So cleanliness is essential to prevent bad odor and to promote comfort. So next is purpose of perineal care. To clean the perineal skin, care are to prevent or eliminate infection and odor, promote healing. We must take care to prevent or eliminate infection and odor, promote healing. Remove secretion and provide comfort. It removes secretion and also provide comfort. To stimulate circulation, to promote the feeling of well-being. To promote the sense of being comfortable. To reduce body odor and improve self-image. So next is principles. To clean the perineum from the cleanest to the less clean area. So we must clean the perineum from the cleanest to the less clean area. Follow standard precautions. So we must follow standard precautions. Maintain patient's privacy. So we must provide privacy to the patient. Proximal level of functioning. So next, patient who required special attention to perineal care. Patients who are unable to do self-care, patients with genitourinary tract infections, patients with incontinence of urine and stool, patients with excessive vaginal drainage, patients with involving catheters, postpartum patients, patients after surgery on the genitourinary system, patients with injury, ulcers or surgery on the perineal area. So next is preliminary assessment for female. Assess the condition of the perineal skin, any itching, irritation, ulcers, edema, drainage, etc. We must evaluate the condition of the perineal skin. If there is any itching, irritation, ulcers, edema, drainage, etc. Assess need and frequency of perineal care. We must assess the need and frequency of perineal care. Assess whether perineal care should be done under an aseptic technique or clean technique. So we must assess that whether the perineal care should be done under an aseptic technique, which is performed under sterile condition, or a clean technique. Check the physician's orders for any specific instruction. We must examine the physician order for any specific instructions. Assess the patient's ability for self-care. We must assess the patient's ability for self-care. Assess the patient's mental state for self-care. We must evaluate the patient's mental state for self-care. Check the articles available in the patient unit. So next is preparation of articles. Macintosh and draw sheet to protect the bed. A jug with warm water to clean perineum. Sterile gauze pieces with the antiseptic lotion to clean the perineum. Artery forceps and thumb forceps on antiseptic lotion to hold swab for cleaning. Kidney tray to receive the waste. Clean line to make the bedding clean. Pads and dressing to keep the patient clean. Bedpan to clean the perineum, or it can be also used if the patient has a need of passing urine or stool. Dried drug pieces to dry the perineum. Drop sheet and screen to maintaining the privacy of the patient.